showing the views. We love part of a community of fellow automobile businesses. Experience all the time exhibits. Make memories that last a lifetime. Be part of our mission to present the history of the automobile to the world and share its global impact on life and culture. Become a member. Peterson Automotive Museum.
Competition just breeds excellence, in my opinion. Nobody exemplifies that more than Porsche.
I was a racer and loved, you know, the shape and look and feel of the 356. I just wanted to make it hard. People who collect cars have multiple Porsches for the same reason. French cars, impressionists need to have more than one. The reason is they're damn good.
I was a racer. this guy chair.
Thank you.
I'm still watching for it.
Thank you. alignment. I don't even see a door.
That's
fun.
Thank you.
Thank you. Historian of the Petersen Automotive Museum in Los Angeles. In fact, Jaguar was on top of the world with their D-types and the C-type that preceded the vehicles that came after. But when the cars started becoming a little bit less competitive, they said, well, you know what, we've got 25 of these left over. They're not going to be really racing competitively anymore. Why don't we take them and turn them into the ultimate in roadblock sports cars, which they did. Unfortunately, they only got around to moving out to 16 of them when there was a fire at the Browns Lane factory that completely destroyed all of the others, including the 9 D-types that were going to be transformed. And what a transformation it would have been, because in order to make this cruising car, the roadblock car, you had to do quite a few adaptations. In fact, you had to add body protection in the form of blue bumperettes. You had to have a full... Hello, my name is Leslie Kendall. I'm the Chief Historian of the Petersen Automotive Museum in Los Angeles. And we're here to talk about million-dollar cars, in particular $1 million car, our 1913 Mercer. We want to talk about what makes it worth so much money and why so many people really, really would like to have one. This 1913 Mercer is probably one of the most significant early cars. And what makes it worth so much money, well into $1 million, is the fact that it's a beautiful car. It's high performance. It cost a lot of money when it was new. It was built to very low tolerances. In other words, it's a high quality car. And it's a very low production. They estimate that only about 250 of these were built over a 4-year span of time. A lot of people look at a $1 million car and they say, well, can I drive it? Is this something I can take out on the road and have a little bit of fun with? And most 1911, 12, 13, 14 cars, you can't. But this Mercer, you can. You can actually take this on the road, you can throw it to a corner, you can have a little bit of fun with it, not too much fun, and get an authentic 1913 driving experience. Part of what makes this car so interesting is the charm that age brings with it. It's a car that requires more driver involvement than most modern cars today, than any modern car today. In fact, when you start it, you have to go through a 6 or 8 step procedure, depending, of course, on whether you live in a snowy climate and it's January, or you live on the West Coast and it's August, depending on how warm or cold it is. Also, if you drive at night, you're going to want to turn on your headlights. But it's not just a matter of reaching down the dashboard and pulling a switch. You have to open the headlight lenses and light them with the match after you turn on the Presto light tank. Presto light is a gas, a very flammable gas that burns a bright white. And headlights properly soldered will throw a beam as far as you can imagine. You also have calo lights that make driving, again, a little bit interesting. It brings an authentic motoring experience to the proceedings. You open the side and you light the wick. So this is a car that has an awful lot going for it. And I think most people would consider this one of America's first sports cars. Keeping in mind that sporting cars are meant to be driven, not necessarily ridden in. The whole idea about driving as a sport is to feel the road, to feel the car, muscle the car around the corners, experience the interaction with the machine from the day. This car offers all of that. Looks good going down the road, and everybody, virtually everybody, knows what a Mercer is. So you've got that name recognition too. Something that makes this car especially important is the fact that is so original. It's probably one of the most original. They weren't original. They weren't as they were. They came out of the Mercer factory in New Jersey. But here you have a car that is highly original, except it was repainted once in the early 1950s, but that's it. The fenders are original. In fact, the numbers match. The fender numbers match the body numbers. It's pretty talented.
Thank you. So June of 1998, we loaded up the trailer in the back, put Zane in the back seat, even upholstered a little baby seat to match the main seats, and we set off on a 4,500-mile journey. Our first stop was Monterey. So what we're seeing here are the quick sketches of the remodeled design. Thank you.
it's the 50th year I've owned that car. I was straight out of high school. My dad knew me.
Thank you. This is Jules' exact car. No, this is literally, this is literally the car Jules got. I don't know if you got a 2023 or 2022. Okay, finally, do we have
has the ¿Viste los cohetes acá, amigo?